our lab is involved in looking at the initial changes in cancer, so how a normal cell becomes a cancer cell.
All throughout the College of Medicine at Penn State Hershey, researchers are hard at work looking for those small discoveries that may eventually lead to cures for any number of diseases. Just as a carpenter relies on his hammer and saw, researchers need their lab equipment for their experiments. Devices like incubators and centrifuges, autoclaves, and biosafety cabinets.
Before this process, every laboratory in the college was an island to itself.
Actually, about 350 islands. That's how many labs are spread across several buildings using thousands of pieces of lab equipment. Because each lab acts independently, there was never a system put in place to help inventory, maintain, and track all of these tools of the research trade. That created waste and inefficiency.
We didn't have a good idea when we first started this program about how much equipment we really did have. And yeah, it's over 4,000 pieces of equipment are in our inventory right now, and that's quite a lot.
So we had a hard time wrapping our arms around all of the dollars that were being spent.
So a small team in the new Research Quality Assurance Office took it upon themselves to develop a new approach, one that would allow researchers to spend less time maintaining their equipment and more time researching.
Principal investigators have a lot going on. I mean, they're doing their experiments, they're working on funding. This is one other thing that we could take from them that they wouldn't have to worry about.
With so much equipment spread across so many labs, that was easier said than done. The team set out to create a defined inventory system for all 4,000 pieces of equipment.
Yeah, this is what the RQA program is all about, which is the inventory of the equipment, and in this case, it's the biological safety cabinet.
Now, all lab equipment is properly tagged and tracked, and when equipment is due to be calibrated or serviced, researchers can simply reach out to the RQA team rather than having to manage that process themselves.
It leaves me time to do more of my research, less of maintaining the equipment. So it's been working out well.
Over the last 2 years, we've seen our repair costs decrease. We've seen the maintenance schedule get less. And, in other words, we're not having as many service calls.
Not only have repair costs dropped, overall lab maintenance expenses are down by more than 10%. The initiative is winning praise for saving both time and money.
When they presented this, there was we weren't all sure how it was going to work, but I really feel in the past couple years it has come together, and I think we really appreciate them taking the initiative to get it started.
The program has been so successful, the RQA team has been invited to present their work at conferences so that other research centers can learn how to implement a similar inventory and maintenance system.
It's rewarding. It's something that we know is helping the institution, and that's what we really wanted to do.
We work hard every day, but we don't always get to see a program of this type develop as a result of our work, and it feels good. That's my reward at the end of the day.
There isn't a day that goes by that I don't enjoy coming here. It sounds a little cheesy, but I mean that, because there's just so much good research going on around here.